Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Opening day is here as we get the new season underway with a good matchup between the Kansas City Royals and the Chicago White Sox. Hello again, everybody. Baseball is back. Welcome to our special opening day broadcast on MLB Network. I'm joined by Dan Plesac. And Dan, as we get things going this season, it's pitching that has to be key if this team's going to have success.
You know, I always think pitching and defense are the keys to success in the long run. So as the season gets started, it's going to be really important for this pitching staff to set a good tone. If they can get off on a good foot, it will do a lot for the confidence of the entire ball club.
The game's count starting now. Opening day on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. Lucas Giolito gets the call to pitch here on opening day in front of the hometown crowd. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
200 strikeouts on the season last year. That's not an easy thing to do. You definitely consider this guy a strikeout pitcher, and if he brings the same stuff that he had last year into this new season, we could see more than 200 strikeouts 2 years in a row.
So coming to the plate, Adalberto Mondesi. He will lead this one off today. First delivery to him on the way. And a swing and a miss for strike one, as that's how this new season of baseball will get underway. Popped him up. Madrigal over to his left. He's got it one away. Digging in now for Kansas City, number 26. He readies for his first plate appearance. Now here's the pitch. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. Giolito has a reputation, or a knack, if you will, for working himself out of tough situations when he finds himself there. A lot of relief pitchers are known for that, obviously, but as a starter, that's certainly a valuable characteristic to have.
Matty V, and I'm going to tell you who likes this. The bullpen likes it, and the manager likes this, because most pitchers are going to get into trouble at least one or two times during the course of a start, and it's nice to know as a manager that you have a guy that's out there that can pitch with men on base and wiggle out of some tough jams. This guy's made a living doing this in his career.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Salvador Perez is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. A ball and a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. A ball and two strikes to the Royals catcher.
If the offense didn't already know, man on the mound's got his A-game fastball working today.
Swing and a miss as he chases one out of the zone for the third strike, and that's the third out of the inning. Royals go down 1-2-3. Now it's the White Sox turn in a scoreless ballgame. So stepping in, Tim Anderson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now here it comes. Hit to short. Mondesi picks it up. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. Coming to the plate now, Nick Madrigal. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Line towards center field. That's a hit, their first of the new season. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark. Nick Madrigal has just collected his first hit in the big leagues. And as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head, he's on top of the world.
A bouncer up the middle. And that's through for a hit. Merrifield scoops it up.
Dan, count goes out the window with this batter right here. It doesn't matter if it's 0-2, 2-0, he's locked.
He has great bat-to-ball skills. There are some guys that just have a knack, D-Row, of being able to get the barrel to the ball, and this is one of those guys.
Into the box now, Eloy Jimenez. Drilled right back up the middle, and that's through into center field. Base hit, long throw to third. And this will come in far too late. He's in there at third.
Hey, D-Row, they're making this guy pay. That's three straight singles and a run driven in.
Yeah, nothing hit extremely hard. Killing them softly, station to station with those knocks.
So now to the plate, Luis Robert. He swings and grounds it to short. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score. And this is pretty cool, guys. Not only is that his first big league hit, it's also his first major league RBI. Not a bad way to get your career started.
Yeah, no doubt, Matty. He took care of the two first with one swing of the bat. So congrats to him on achieving something that's really special that he's worked so very hard for. He'll never forget this moment as long as he lives.
Edwin Encarnacion to the plate now as the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. Another first inning RBI opportunity for him here. One ball and one strike to their designated hitter this afternoon. Fouled away. Here's the 1-2. Rarely do you see a player of his caliber fooled that badly, but he was tied up in knots that time. Two away now. Now batting, Yoan Moncada. And the White Sox looking for more here in the game's opening frame. First pitch on its way. And a half-hearted swing there as he tried to go the other way, and it's strike one. This one is launched. Look at this. And it's gone.
Spring training feeling pretty good about your swing. And how about this? Your first at bat of the year. Kaboom. This could lead to a very big year. First at bat, home run. Not a bad way to start.
And here's the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one.
He definitely doesn't look himself to start this one. And this lineup needs to be on the attack early and be aggressive and find a way to stay in this game.
And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Wow, this guy must be a glutton for punishment because he's given up six hits in this inning alone. Not sure how much more rope you can give this guy. At some point, you have to try somebody different.
Adam Eaton digging in next as he'll chase one up around the letters here for strike one. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. Soler going back, and he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. But not before five crossed the plate, with the big blow being this three-run home run. Second inning coming up, and the lead is now 5-0. In is Jorge Soler. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
So many things run through a pitcher's mind in this situation when your offense gives you a big lead. A, you know you got to pot commit and get aggressive with that fastball. You got a smile on your face because you have the lead, but you want to continue to attack and try and stay in this game as long as possible.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. 2-2 to Jorge Soler.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Rip down the line. Moncada has it. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Whit Merrifield next to bat. Past history with Lucas Giolito. He's totaled four hits in 25 tries. He also has one home run. The windup and the 0-1. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. This is foul right side. Bases are empty, one man out. Merrifield behind, a ball and two strikes.
Hey, struggling to find the release point of that curveball. That wasn't a very good one. Somehow he's just got to find that feel because that's a pitch he's going to need going forward.
And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now. Digging in now, Michael Franco, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. 0-1 the count. And the Royals are in the hit column for the first time this year.
You'll only see about 10 of these pitches a year. The changeup on a tee in the middle of the plate. But tip your hat to the batter right there. He did not come unglued, stayed within himself, and drove it for a base hit.
Hunter Dozier is next as he finds himself behind 0-1. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. And he fouls this one off. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss as the slider sets him down for the final out of the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the big time power threat, Tim Anderson.
Even though they're up by a boatload early on in this one, you can't get complacent and get lazy. They got to keep the gas pedal down because this team that they're playing can strike and score a lot of runs too.
And a good throw gets him one gone. Now at the plate, Nick Madrigal. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. On the ground to the left side. Throw gets him, two down. Standing in, Jose Abreu. He singled his last time up. And a good fastball there, but this just misses the zone for ball one.
Wouldn't mind a pitcher expanding the zone a little bit more and using his aggressiveness against them.
That evens it up, 1-1. Now here's the pitch. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. Down in order go the White Sox, but they hold a 5-0 lead. So striding in, Edward Olivares, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. And 2-0 as this one's taken low.
Boy, you don't see that very often out of a rookie. That's a 2-0 count, and both of those pitches were really close. This guy has a pretty good eye.
That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. With that, the Royals have their leadoff hitter aboard to start out the inning. Stepping in now, Michael Taylor, as he'll send a ground ball down to third. And that's the first down. Back to the top of the order now, and striding toward the plate next will be Adalberto Mondesi. Here comes the first pitch. One out and a runner on second base. A curveball hit right back at him, and he'll send it on to first, and that'll freeze the runner at second with two away now. At the plate, number 26, runner in scoring position with Sugan. First delivery to him on the way. Swing and a looper to left. Jimenez coming in. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. One left for Kansas City. Need to get it going soon. It's 5-0. Bottom of the third now, and standing in the outfielder, Eloy Jimenez. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball here, 0-1. And the pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Pretty textbook pitching right there. Jump ahead in the count 0-2 and then start working outside the zone. Easier said than done, but that's the way to do it.
Hit hard to third. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit. They've gotten their hits in deep counts. They've gotten their hits in early counts. This has been a real onslaught.
Yeah, you can look at it one of two ways, Matty. Either they have a ton of respect for the man on the mound and they are just going to ambush tactics and it seems to work for them. Or you can look at it the other way. They're just getting lucky.
Edwin Encarnacion now. And it's fouled away. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. And 0-2 count to Edwin Encarnacion. And this ball is popped up, drifting back behind the mound. Number 26 is under it, two gone. So here's Yoan Moncada. First delivery to him on the way.
Off the plate, ball one.
Pitches away, but it's swung on and grounded to second. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. New inning set to get underway, and up next, the former World Series hero, Salvador Perez. And this will be swung on and bounced on the ground to second. And that's through for a base hit. Make him 1-for-2 in this one.
Dan, that can't bother you too much as a pitcher. Guy swinging first pitch.
No, one of the things you want to do, D-Rose, you have to try to get ahead with the first pitch. You want to throw one of the first two pitches for strikes. Unfortunately, sometimes when you bring the ball in the strike zone, you're bound to give up some base hits. But hopefully he can minimize the damage here.
2-1, here it is. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Robert will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. In now, Whit Merrifield, 0-for-1 after he took a look at strike three in his first plate appearance. From the stretch. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, it's 0-2.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Runner on first in a double play situation, so you expect to see a lot of pitches down in the zone. So I think that pitch up right there was a good one. Obviously, the double play is more efficient, but you're always going to take a K when you're on the mound.
Slider, and he can't pull the trigger. Two strikes. Fouled off.
Hey, that fastball caught too much of the plate on an 0-2 count.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Waiting on it is Jimenez, and that ends the inning. Royals leave one. They can't chip into that 5-0 deficit. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up Yasmani Grandal. First pitch of the at bat. Hit sharply on the ground. There is Franco, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So the base is empty here with one away, and the next to bat is speedy Adam Eaton.
Nope.
Lays off 1-0.
All one, no strike.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
This offense is absolutely feasting on these count leverage situations. If he's going to have any chance of feeling good about his effort tonight, this pitcher has got to get back in the strike zone.
The 2-1 home. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at-bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
I had him lunging at that pitch away, and it's 1-1 now. Grounded weakly toward third. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the White Sox as they're unable to add to their 5-0 lead. Ball set for the start of the inning, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Hunter Dozier.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going, and the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
Strike one to start the at-bat. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Waiting on it is Jimenez. He's got it one away. Now at the plate, Edward Olivares. He reached on a single in his first try. Here's the pitch. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Down the line and fair, that's a hit. The throw into second, but he'll be in there with a double. Standing in now, Michael Taylor. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. No runs, four hits, and no errors so far for the Royals. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. All even now, 2-2.
After fouling off the second one, I got to step out of the box, adjust my batting gloves, and tell myself there's no chance he's tripling up on that pitch.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Ready once again, Adalberto Mondesi. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. Out in front as he rolls over it to second. Reined in. Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it, the side is retired. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. Home half of the fifth coming up, and the White Sox are out in front, 5-0. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and set to go is the second baseman, Nick Madrigal. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. And now that Royals bullpen will get busy as we see both a southpaw and a right-hander get loose. Swing and a miss here, and he's behind in the count now, 0-2. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time.
He wasn't even close to swinging right there. That was a stone cold take.
Popped up, Keller is under it. He's got it one away. So one away here with the bases empty. And one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
And everyone knows that you set the tone on opening day, and that's not the kind of tone they want to set. They made fielding a priority in the spring, but it doesn't translate on that play. Might be some early season jitters, too.
Irvin Santana is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Pitch is popped up. Mondesi is there, makes the play, and there are two gone now. So striding forward now, Luis Robert. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. Here comes the first pitch. Good slider there, gets a swing and miss. Abreu, the runner at first with two gone. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
The 1-2. Hit high and deep out to left center field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. White Sox leave one, but they hold a 5-0 lead. Stepping up to the plate, number 26. And Dan, he and his fellow top of the order hitters haven't really offered much help for this lineup so far.
No, your 1-2-3 guys are the ones you look to generate a lot of action. And they just haven't been up to the task so far in this one. Still time for them to turn it around, though. We'll see if it happens.
Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel of that one.
That's in there on the outer half. 1-2 now. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Man, this guy's on his game today, not only when he's throwing strikes, but how about the amount of strikeouts? And what's even more impressive, no walks up to this point. So he's pounding that zone with strikes, and he's making these hitters swing the bat.
Salvador Perez stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
Front door with the slider. He clips the zone for a called strike. Swung on and belted to left by Perez. This one's deep. Jimenez is back to the track as he takes it for out number two. So here's the cleanup hitter, Jorge Soler. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. And he lays off a pitch here that he probably shouldn't have. 0-1.
Man, this guy's been incredibly efficient so far in this one, mostly because he's getting ahead. 70% of the batters he's faced, he's thrown a first pitch strike to.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2. No runs, four hits, one error so far for Kansas City. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. KC down in order. Need to get it going soon. It's 5-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and digging in is the veteran DH, Edwin Encarnacion. Now here's the pitch.
Ball one, no strike.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So a solo home run for Edwin Encarnacion. First home run of the campaign for him. As they pile on, it's now 6-0.
Listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, is not the end of the world.
Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. He'll swing and lift a ball foul off to the left and out of play. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swung on, and this one's driven in the air as well to deep right field. And it's gone as they add still another. A solo home run for Yoan Moncada. His second of the game as this lead swells to 7-0.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
The catcher, Yasmani Grandal. Hit hard down the line, but this is foul for the first strike. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner, and that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Fouled away. Bases are empty here. Nobody out. And he fouls this one off. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Well, no one really likes getting plunked by a pitch, but as long as it doesn't do too much damage, most guys will take it any day. A free pass can be a big deal if the guys behind you can make it hurt for the pitcher.
Digging in, Adam Eaton. No hits to this point. From the stretch. Nobody out, runner on first. And it's fouled away. Here's the 0-2.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
Here comes another 0-2. A double play ball to second. 4-6-3, and they turn the double play. So base is empty now after the double play. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Tim Anderson. This is flared out towards second. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. Seventh inning coming up. It's the White Sox 7 and the Royals nothing. Digging in once again, Whit Merrifield. We'll start things out against Lucas Giolito as we get the inning underway.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Here now the 2-2. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. On the run is Jimenez. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Stepping into the box, Michael Franco. A hit and two tries for him so far. And it's 0-1 to the Kansas City first baseman.
Hey, it's always key getting early strikes in a count. This guy's been awesome at it so far. More than 70% of his first pitches have been in the strike zone.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and the pitch. Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game. And that brings in Hunter Dozier. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First pitch of the at bat. Fouled off. Breaking ball down around the knees, laid off and called a strike.
Boy, this guy's got it going on right now. He's executing everything. He should feel pretty good. He's retired 7 in a row.
Off speed pitch, just missed inside.
Great arm action on that 2-strike changeup right there, but even better job at the plate to take that one.
Still a ball and 2 strikes. 2 out, nobody on. And another foul ball.
He was looking for a swing and a miss breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
Here's a pop up now. Grandal has a play, and that's the 3rd out. This one pretty well in the bag. We'll move on now to the bottom half of the 7th. Get up and stretch. It's the White Sox 7 and the Royals nothing. Mike Montgomery comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. Ready for another shot now, Nick Madrigal. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Hit on the ground is short. Mondesi brings it in. And the inning begins with a quick out number 1. So here's Jose Abreu. He was able to reach base thanks to an error in his last at bat. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Abreu's going to head for second. And he's in there easily at second with a 1-out double.
Wow, he must be living right because he gets absolutely jammed. Thought we were going to see the bat splintered, but instead he muscles the ball to right for a double. Might get some heckles from his teammates, but no doubt he'll take it.
Well, plate now, Eloy Jimenez, as he'll take a look at ball one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Striding into the box, Luis Robert. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
And a foul pop behind the plate. And he will indeed make the play in foul territory to retire the side. A man left for the White Sox, but they're still in control, 7-0. Digging in and looking for more, Edward Olivares. He doubled his last time through.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Michael Taylor comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. The 0-1. Hit hard. Foul.
And when a guy starts leaving the curveball up, that's a sign he's beginning to tire a little bit out there. He's got to be able to get on top of that pitch or he's going to start getting hurt.
And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Adalberto Mondesi. He struggled at the top of the lineup in this one, hitless to this point. A bouncer to the left side. Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it, the side is retired. Royals go down 1-2-3. They need to get something cooking here. It's 7-0. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up the power bat of Edwin Encarnacion.
Yeah, that last at bat, Daddy, he turned it.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And it's gone as they add still another. A solo shot here to left. His second home run of the game as they've widened this lead to 8 now. They've got the elevate and celebrate thing working in this one, guys. That was their fourth big fly of the game.
Matty V, D-Row, I don't know what you think, but this is like crazy. Fourth round triple of the game so far. They're missing a good part of the plate, not using the quadrants. In the hitters meeting, they focused on this stuff. They thought these guys could miss middle, and that's exactly what's happening.
Liner towards second, but this will be gloved out there at second as he didn't have far to go for the out. Digging in, the switch hitter, Yasmani Grandal. One run in and one gone so far in this inning. Here comes the first pitch. High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas? Oh, hang on now. This ball is smoked to right, and I don't think this one's coming back. No chance. It's gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. First home run of the campaign for him as they've pushed this lead up to 9 now. On to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. In now is Adam Eaton as he sends it on the ground to first. flip comes to Kennedy covering for the out. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He was a ground out victim last time up. And this is popped foul, but perhaps playable behind first. And no one will get this one. Kennedy sets his sights. 0-1 pitch on its way. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Chasing after it is Taylor. He makes the catch. What a play on the run. At the plate, number 26, starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point. These guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional.
Line to the right side. Ah, but that finds the first baseman's glove, and that's a tough first out. Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. His dominance continues on the mound, but it seems like he might be running on adrenaline only at this point.
Yeah, he's been so great in this one. You want to see him finish what he started, but you also have to start worrying about things like injuries. He's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, and some guys are just more capable of that than others, but not a lot of good things tend to happen when you've worked as hard as he has in this one.
No walks yet. Here's the delivery. And he'll just make him throw one over here. 3-1.
That's a tough curveball right there to stay into as a lefty hitter. That ball looks like it's almost going to hit you, and it breaks over the inside half of the plate.
Perez will lay off, and he'll reach. It's ball four. Digging in, Jorge Soler. And after that quick walk, is it fair to wonder if this starter is beginning to show signs of getting tired?
Yeah, that could be the case, Matty. Sometimes you just lose your focus, lose your command, but it'll be real important for him to get it back as this next hitter walks up to the plate.
This is line to left. Jimenez is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Whit Merrifield next to hit. He's their last shot here with two away in the ninth as they look to avoid the shutout.
Yeah, Matt, they just haven't had any answer for the great pitching so far in this one.
Ball one to start the at-bat. That command may be starting to drift a bit. It's 2-0 now.
If you've been picking.
Oh, and meanwhile, this pitch rides too far in and winds up hitting him. Digging in, Michael Franco. And his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position. He's got it, and the White Sox move to 1-0 on the young season as this ball game is over.
Yeah, and we knew he was in a groove from the first inning, and he just kept this thing rolling and rolling and rolling. They couldn't get anything going against him. A dominant performance with a complete game shutout.
A 9-0 shutout final in this ball game. The Chicago White Sox sent five balls over the wall to come out on top in this one. Lucas Giolito earns his first win of the season as he racked up 10 strikeouts in the effort. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.